Georgia.
We on the grind in
Georgia
all the time. It ain't nothing on my mind but
Georgia.
We ain't playing with you. We on the-
Next up, we're going to hear from Morris, Manning, and Martin.
Like Belle Biv DeVoe. Right.
Yeah. Well, we're going to have one representative from Morris, Manning, and Martin here today. But for those who don't know, Morris, Manning, and Martin is an international first full-service law firm with offices right here in Atlanta. We're pleased to welcome one of their partners from the firm, Austin Mills. Hi, Austin.
Hi. Hi, everybody. It's great to be here.
I want to know a little bit more about specifically the fintech and payment clients that you and your firm work with.
Yeah. So as you mentioned, we're a sort of full service firm. You know, we're based in Atlanta, but we work heavily with, you know, clients around the world. And our fintech practice is in large part, you know, sort of strongly tied into our corporate technology practice as a whole, right? So you know, our corporate practice is heavily focused on tech and tech enabled businesses, as well as the PE, VC growth and other investor community that serves them. So we've really built a practice around sort of that audience. I mean, we also work with, you know, larger incumbents and financial institutions, but there's a, you know, a significant focus within the fintech practice on sort of the more emerging, sort of disruptive, growth oriented tech and tech enabled businesses in the space. We also, you know, I think somewhat different than a lot of firms, we focus a lot on sort of non-legal value added services, whether it's introduction to sources of capital, connecting with management talent or other potential resources, connecting our clients with strategic partners and potential customer relationships. And so we really try to help our clients, you know, grow, and it sort of built the practice around that. And I think specializing in technology first, but then also, you know, having subspecialties within fintech, payments, and other verticals really helps us sort of, you know, specialize around the unique needs of that audience and that sort of client base.
Excellent. Well, that leads to the question, those specialized sort of unique needs. Tell me a little bit about them. What are the legal and, you know, I guess, regulatory issues that clients face in the fintech space?
Yeah, I mean, that's one of the unique aspects of a, you know, a fintech practice, you know, maybe a little bit like healthcare, but a lot of other industries, they don't necessarily have the same sort of robust regulatory environment to navigate, right? So it's everything from money transmission and money service businesses laws, you know, related AML, KYC, and OFAC, you know, the CFPA, payment network rules and regulations, PCI, data privacy and security, lending and related laws. I mean, it's, you know, you quickly get into an alphabet soup of acronyms whenever, you know, when you get into fintech and payments and financial institutions. So on the regulatory side, it, you know, it's pretty wide ranging. And that, I mean, that inevitably carries over into sort of, you know, most other aspects of that company's business. So, you know, on the legal side, when we're helping clients navigate those commercial relationships, right, we have to account for the regulatory reality, the, you know, the reality of having strong incumbent players in the space that have leverage, right? So, you know, we try to take a practical common sense approach to help clients solve problems. You're not going to, you know, you're not going to get into a negotiation with a large bank that you're asking to partner with you on your sort of novel new emerging product and then, you know, dictate the rules to them. You're going to have to, you know, more practically work within their expectations and their limitations and their framework. And so I think, you know, being able to focus in fintech and in payments, you know, gives you the ability to see where those challenges are, how they can be navigated, how you can sort of solve those problems and how you can, you know, help clients get done what they need to get done to do what they want to do. While also, you know, accounting for the reality of you know, the regulatory environment and, you know, the large incumbent players and the power that they have.
I'm interested, when you're working with fintech within the fintech space, is that very different than when you're working with other others in the corporate space?
It often is. I mean, there's certain things that are the same, right? I mean, you know, companies have the same core organizational needs and things like that. But it really is, you know, for example, right? If you're a fintech company and you want to get involved in payments flow and move money, you're inevitably going to have to partner with a bank or some other sort of regulated financial institution or a, you know, a large, you know, maybe a large merchant acquirer core processor. And, you know, as opposed to other industries where, you know, commercial relationships, you know, again, they don't have to necessarily always navigate the regulatory environment. They don't have to navigate their partner's, you know, regulatory environment, which can often be different. And so you kind of just have to come to the table knowing that, you know, whereas in a non-fintech type commercial transaction, you might expect some set of terms and some sort of, you know, risk parameters, you might not be able to pull that off when you're partnering with a large financial institution, right? Their risk profile is much narrower. And so they account for that when they're partnering with you. The regulatory environment also sort of limits, you know, how this can look. So yeah, I think, you know, a lot of times the job is really just, you know, as opposed to getting the, you know, perfect agreement, it's helping the client to most efficiently navigate the challenges to get where they need to be, and do it in an efficient manner so that, you know, they still have a market by the time they've checked all the boxes that they need to check.
Would you say that specifically, since fintech is obviously within an innovation sort of space and new technologies, would you say that you find yourself as, you know, counsel kind of answering some questions that, you know, even outside of the normal day-to-day of you and your expertise in this field, sort of kind of relates to like a newer age, even sort of client with this whole new emerging industry?
Yeah, no, absolutely. I mean, and that is both what's kind of fun about the job, but what can also be more challenging and more frustrating, right? I mean, every day someone's coming up with a new idea, a new way to do something, a new way to solve a problem. You know, we're working, you know, with entrepreneurs who, you know, there's no challenge that they can't tackle. You know, for example, right? I mean, when cryptocurrency really emerged, we have this whole body of law, you know, around payments, around this, around that. And now we have this new technology, this new paradigm. And it's not really clear to anyone how the new paradigm fits within the existing framework, both the regulatory framework as well as sort of how that interfaces with the, you know, the legacy systems and the incumbent players. And so we're trying to find the best answers we can, right? With a level of unknowns that's not always common in the law. We like certainty. We like, you know, it's easier when there are straightforward rules to apply. But, you know, most of the regulatory framework was developed in a, you know, an era where it's just a different market, right? I mean, you had banks, you had the large payment rails, the card networks, and then, you know, a lot of the regulation also came in the early days, you know, more in the Western Union, MoneyGram, in the early days of PayPal. And, you know, especially when it comes to things like money transmission. And now, as you see, you know, everything's up for grabs, right? Every little market, every little payment rail, every challenge someone's going after, trying to do it a different way, trying to do it a better way, trying to make it more efficient. But, you know, having to do that within a regulatory framework that was drafted around, you know, a different sort of generation of the market, it often presents challenges. And so we're trying to put clients in the best position possible to succeed.
Setting precedents every day, I guess, huh?
Yeah, well, not ideally, but yeah, inevitably, I think so.
Great.
Awesome. Well, Austin, we really appreciate your time today, and we're I hope you enjoyed the rest of your time here at Fintech South.
Absolutely. Thank you guys so much. Georgia, we on the grind in Georgia.